If you are talking about Agile release trains and Agile analytics, one of the best things I can tell you from a corporate perspective is to look at the scaled Agile framework definition of what an Agile release train is. At its core, it's a group of teams, a group of people that are organized under a common purpose. So you may have, for example, a group of teams that are working on a product or a specific piece of information. You can organize that into an Agile release train, right? So it's really that grouping of people working on something similar, you know, and SAFe characterizes it as a long-term set of teams working on a goal. So that's kind of what an Agile release train is in a nutshell. Analytics are always important, right? You're working hard to achieve something. You always want to see how you're doing and how you can improve. Not because you want to use a carrot and a stick, but you're really interested in improving. One of the tenets of Agile is around inspecting and adapting. So you have to see that so you can get better. And Agile analytics, or analytics in general, help you do that. You can take analytics at the team level. You can take analytics at the team of team level. You know, we look at things like cycle time, team velocity, team throughput, team predictability, right? So those are just a few of the analytics that you should be looking at and really using those as part of your retrospectives in order to make sure, again, that you're improving what you're doing, you know, and how you're doing it, because your teams always want to do a better job and you want to enable them to do that. Software companies can use Agile analytics, or analytics as a whole, really, to not only understand what they're doing, but how they're doing it. You always want to improve, not in a carrot and a stick method, but you always want to get better at what you're doing and be more efficient. So software companies are going to be using Agile analytics to do that.